simple particle. So let us know about the aim of the practical. Our aim of the practical is to know the effective length of the second pendulum. Second pendulum means cosine period is at 2 seconds. So we need to find the length of that pendulum. Secondly, we need to draw the graph between the L and the T square. So check the apparatus required. Apparatus required is the jam stand, any type of the metallic bar, your stopwatch, as well as the meter scale. So first of all, we need to find about the effective length. How will we know or calculate the effective length? Effective length is an actually length from the point of suspension to the center of the bobbin. Center of the bobbin, it means that includes length of the string as well as the length of the hook plus the radius of the bobbin. The radius of the bobbin we can calculate with the help of the Bernier calipers that we have already learned in the earlier practicals. After knowing about the length of the pendulum and the radius of the bob, it helps us to each time calculation of the effective length. It means if we require the length of the 40 cm, in that case, we subtract the value of the hook as well as the radius of bob. Now, after knowing about the length of the pendulum, it's the time to take the time to calculate the period for the various number of the oscillations for either different length. First, let me consider I am taking the length of 37.3 to make the 40 cm. As I have told you earlier, the 2.7 is already calculated for the size of the hook as well as the radius of curvature. By knowing the length, we need to be oscillate with the 20 times as we have to find the time period for the 20 oscillations. Now, for the oscillations, what we have to do? First, we have to fix the center of mass or the center of mass, or we can say the mean position of the pendulum. This we can be fixed by placing a scale over here just to make it clear. Now, at the time of the oscillations, what I do? I ready with my stopwatch. I provide the oscillations by making the bob displaced by 2 or 3 degrees from its mean position. As I displaced, complete to and fro motion makes one oscillation. We need to find 20 oscillations. We need to find time for the 20 oscillations. So let us count them by making the watch ready. Our watch moves and we count them in the form of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Let us close the watch and note the time interval. Repeat the same procedure for the same length. It means we need to take the mean for avoid any type of the error. Now come to the point, after taking the length as well as the time period, we come to the point as we have ready. Let us take about the observation table. The observation table required the length, which I have stated you, the radius of the bob is 1.2 cm, whereas the length of the hook is 1.5, that makes 2.7 cm. So, the length we require to make the 40 cm, subtract the 40 minus 2.3, which will be the 37.3. So, at the 37.3, for 20 oscillations, the time taken by the stopwatch is 25 seconds in the first time, whereas second time it will be the 26 seconds. So first take the mean, that is the 26 seconds. After taking the mean for the 20 oscillations, let us calculate the time, that is capital letter T, for the one oscillation by dividing it by 20. We get the 1.3 seconds. It means 1.3 second is the mean time for calculating one oscillation at the length of 40 cm. Let them make them square of it, that is the 1.39. Follow the same pattern for the different length as we have taken. First we have taken at the 37.3, next for the 47.3, 57.3. Let us calculate, or we have to take the 7 or 8 reading to plot the graph, as the graph is quite stable by the various number of the readings. Now, after calculating the length and the time, our aim is to calculate the graph or to calculate the pendulum's time period, as well as the we need to be draw the graph between the length and the time square. Let us come on the graph. On the x-axis we need to be taken the L, and for the y-axis we need to be taken the square of the time period. Before plotting the graph, we should mention the scale. On the x-axis, in which we are showing the L, here 10 cm represents the 1 unit, whereas on the time axis, our 1 section or the 1 unit represents the 1 second. Now, by knowing the value of L and T, with the help of the observation table, plot the graph and join the point as much as you can, and it should be start from the origin. After joining the graph, we find the intersection point. Our intersection point is at length of 100 cm on the time period of 4 seconds. This is our required value. The length of the pendulum whose time period is 2 seconds is 100 cm. Hopefully it is quite clear to you. Thank you.